YouTube, what's going on? Gary here with another video. So last time you guys saw me do some engine guard installs. I gotta say the weather's been doing a lot better recently, but I've been a bit distracted. I got this beautiful thing right in front of me right now, so why don't you just take a peek at this. So I went out and I bought myself a Subaru BRZ. And for the past month and a half, I've been tinkering pretty much on that, giving myself something to do while I was waiting for the weather to turn for the bike. And now the weather's turned, and not only can you see the car here, but you get to see the bike in the back. So in general, I thought I was going to turn this channel into a little bit more than just bike stuff, and I'm going to, but for right now I have a lot more bike stuff to show you. So without further ado, let's get into it a little bit. Okay, so first things first, I had to get this thing up on a stand. Now this is a Dyna. This is the Lowrider S 2016. You guys know that by this point, hopefully. But Dynas have an oil pan that protrudes below the frame rails on the underside of the bike. So you can't just get a regular motorcycle lift and slap it straight on there and lift it up, because you're going to crush the holy crap out of that oil pan. So Harley sells a little kit for like, I think I paid $20 for it, something like that. It's cheap. It's basically just three plastic pieces that attach to the frame rail on the underside, and then one little plastic clip as well. So let me show you how those work real fast so you get an idea of that. My girlfriend hooked me up with this motorcycle stand because we're going to Sturgis together, and she was all about getting this thing set up properly, so she bought the stand for me. So take a look at how this works real quick. So if you can make out on the underside there, there's the little orange and black blocks. The orange parts are going around the frame, and the black blocks give it an extension to help lift it up. So on the left side of the bike, which you're looking at now, you have blocks front and rear that connect to the stand. And on the rear side, you only have a front block. And then the rear piece is just this little plastic chunk. The bike's not even technically sitting on, but it's supposed to be a bracer for this extension around the edge of the oil pan on the underside of the frame rail. I was supposed to have hog straps, apparently, to be able to tie it down, but I just had a couple of come-alongs, and I winched it down no problem, and it's pretty damn stable. I'm pretty happy with it. But I'm in the process of doing some stuff. I started it last night, and I got frustrated with it, and I walked away. And now I'm back, and I'm going to be showing you guys where I'm at, what I'm doing, and explaining the process a little bit. So the things that I'm doing right now, I'm putting a turn signal relocator and license plate relocator on the bike. So that's the license plate relocator. It's just a little frame bracket with arms that go underneath the fender here. And basically, you gotta tear out all the lighting, disconnect everything from the inside right through here. Not that hard to do. The trick with it is you have to have the bike up on a stand for this, or at least be able to get the whole bike rear end into the air in some way, shape, or form. I've jacked up the bike before by using a speed jack and just trying to hold it, and while I successfully did it, it was probably the stupidest thing I've ever done. I would highly not recommend that. Okay, so basically what you're trying to do here is trying to get enough clearance between the rear tire and the fender so that you can work underneath it, run all the wiring, and be able to put in the new mounting brackets. The problem with that is that the suspension is in the way. Even if you manage to get the bike off of the ground on the rear end, the suspension's holding you in. So I made a really dumb mistake here, and I'm going to recommend you guys don't do that. This is like part of the reason why I just walked away last night. I got so fed up with it, and so I was hurting myself and being stupid. And what I did, I decided that it would be a good idea to get the bike all the way in the air, and then, after the fact, disconnect my suspension right here. So I disconnected my suspension on both sides, and as I dropped the second bolt out all the way, I was like, oh, I'll just catch the rear tire. It's not going to be that heavy. Yeah, I smashed the shit out of my fingers. So, don't do that. Don't be me. Because that really sucked. It was not fun. So yeah, suspension's disconnected right now on the rear end. I got the tire down all the way, and I'm in the process of working it through. So what I'm running into By the way, just so you have an idea, I got the rear turn signal and license plate relocator from Great Bike Gear. I went hunting like crazy to find a part that would work well, because Harley wants $200 and some each for the license plate relocator and the turn signal relocator. And even then, I went so far as to order the parts from my Harley dealership in Piqua and find out that they weren't right. So I had them return all that, and I'm trying again. But instead of ordering parts through them, spending $400 on the whole thing, I managed to get this turn signal and license plate relocator and the turn signal fins, I guess you'd call them. These little guys right here. Basically, you have to buy those separate, and you can get them from Harley or Great Bike Gear. We'll sell them to you too. I just bought the ones from Great Bike Gear, but I got all that for $170. So that was a pretty good deal. I'm in the process of trying to get that in, and the issue I've been running into, which I was just trying to get to, is soldering. Come walk with me. So the instruction manual mentions absolutely nothing about soldering, or having to at least cut wires and redo them. But what you're going to run into is that your turn signals have this little bracket right here. And this little thing, for the life of me, I can't get to detach. It's got a little flip lid right here. If you look closely in there, you can see that they're crimped in, all three wires on both turn signals. And I can't get those crimps to come loose. So as an alternative, what I did is I severed the wires right here so that I could get the old turn signal sleeve off and put the new one on right here. But in the process of doing that, I didn't think about it. And this is why I ended up walking away last night, because I've reattached everything. I soldered it and everything, did it the right way. I totally forgot to run the wiring through the frame side. By frame side, I mean running through this hole right here. So this is your mounting hole in the front, well, the rear of the bike, front of the bracket, and then this is where your wiring is going to protrude through, and it's going to go up along the little liners on the underside of the fender and pop back out through this hole right here and into your center compartment underneath your seat. So I just failed at doing the soldering properly because I failed to move it like I should have. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to relocate my entire soldering operation and re-sever those wires and then solder it all up. And hopefully, I should be able to get this done within a couple hours. On top of that, I have one more install to do on this bike today. When I bought the seat for it, the English, I bought the Tallboy seat from Harley. The seat is fantastic. It's the most comfy thing ever. It's kind of fugly, but you know, it works. And I'm dealing with it because I'm going long distances on it. When I first bought the bike, the mirrors were perfect. I could see everything behind me. I bought the seat, suddenly I'm sitting 2 inches higher. I can't see shit anymore. It's like riding my crotch rocket again. So what I bought was mirror extensions from an aftermarket brand, like $25. Basically, they're going to give me 2 more inches of height on the mirrors. So after I get done with this whole relocator kit setup, I'm going to try to get that fired on and see how that goes. So I'll keep you posted. So what I've got going right here is I just dummy mounted my right turn signal on here. And I've got the wire right here. I disconnected the old solders that I had and put some fresh heat shrink on there. And I've got the actual connector right here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to re-solder these all together. And then I'll heat shrink it all down after I tape it up real quick. And then I'm going to do the exact same thing on the other side. Then I'll finish the mount on both of these. Basically, just need to tighten down the turn signal after I get it up like this. I'm just holding it like this so that I can access the cord more easily. And we're going to go from there. Once I get this part done, it'll just be running the wiring back underneath the fender, which it's got some little channels for you to run, which are really handy actually. And then reconnecting everything on the front, and they're even color-coded, so you got brown for brown, white for white on the left turn signal, and then your brake light signal has nothing on it. So pretty easy for the most part. So funny story, I haven't soldered since I was in my early teens, so probably 15 years. I've had these guns lying around for an eon. And I finally decided to do it this way. When I did a fender eliminator on my old ZX6R, I just taped it up and used the little crimps that are like channel crimps that allow you to conduct the electricity through a little conduit that holds both ends of the cable. But I struggled with that and waterproofing it. I was getting shorts in my taillights because of it. So this time I said, screw it, let's do it the right way. And I got my kit out. And the nice thing about solder is that it cools down and dries really damn fast. So while that heat gun's gonna stay hot for a good chunk of time, this right here, these are already solid connections. So I don't know how well you can see that, but boom, I got my three wires there. So my next step is gonna be taking just a little strip of electrical tape on each of those three connectors. You don't need a lot, just a wee little bit. And I'm gonna use that to make sure that I'm not crossing wires at any point, because solder is conductive, just like the wiring is. So cover each one with a little piece, take the heat shrink, slip it over the top, hit the lighter to it to suck it all down tight, and boom, you got a waterproof sealed electrical setup that's pretty damn easy. Soldering kits are like 10 bucks, and while it may seem intimidating, it's really not that hard. I mean, if you're willing to do this kind of crap right here and knock on a fender eliminator, I'm guaranteeing you, you've probably got the ability to solder. So give it a shot. And there you have it. Heat shrinked, sealed, ready to go. On the plus side too, by cutting it right behind the electrical prong, this is going to be sitting in that little compartment underneath your seat, and it's going to be a lot more waterproof that way than if you were to like do your cut right at the rear fender, where you're going to have the tire slinging water up on it left and right. So it's a good idea to cut it up close to where you're going to have less to worry about. Just make sure you give yourself enough slack. Hey. So I am obviously no soldering expert because, like I said, my experience or lack thereof, but what I've been finding is that like you solder something, it looks really good from the top, and then you realize, oh, that looks like shit on the underside. So I tried to go back on two of them and fix them, and I ended up making them worse for a second. So it's a learning curve. The biggest thing I can say about soldering is don't try to apply the solder directly to the connections. Apply the solder to the tip of the gun next to the connections and let it just drip and melt down onto where you're going. And voila, two of two. Nice and clean, pretty much watertight, and looking good. What I noticed, I've already ran and connected the other two wires, and just moving the turn signal back, what, this 4 inches right here, significantly shortens your free play on your cable. So make sure you're not sacrificing any cable length, otherwise you might end up splicing more electrical line in there to make it all work, and that just sucks. And then make sure you're not leaving any slack when you're running into the channel clips for the wiring in the inside of the fender, because like I literally had maybe an inch to play with up front instead of the 3 or 4 that I'd had beforehand. So it makes a difference. We have working lights. So this is what your final product's gonna look like. Another thing to note, which I didn't talk about earlier, is your license plate light is actually going to come out of the fixture, if I can find where I put it, on your old license plate. So basically there's two bolts right here. You can't see when I'm doing that. Basically there's two bolts. You unscrew the bolts and a back plate comes off, and then the wire comes out from back through this little groove right here and runs up this channel. And that channel is, it's glued in, so you gotta yank pretty damn hard, but the wiring is sealed all the way into the light fixture itself. On the underside, you can see it coming in right there. So you don't actually have to worry about waterproofing that. It's already fully autonomous and good to go. The kit comes with these two bracket screws right here with lock nut washers. My dogs are going crazy. So you're good to go on that one. And that one, I didn't have any issues with cable length. So that was good news. The one thing that the kit said to make sure of is, if you can see, I've got the cable running right here. And they said to watch to make sure that you had tire clearance on the cable. And that's a very good question as to whether I'm going to have that or not. So I'm going to potentially have to mount the cable with a zip tie or something up into the corner to try to make sure it's good. Turn signal 1 functioning properly. Turn signal 2 functioning properly. Four ways functioning properly. Front brake lights work. Rear brake lights work. Boom, that's a successful install right there. Now I just gotta slap it all back together. Okay, so like I said yesterday, I had my girlfriend here when I was putting the bike onto the lift. It's going to be significantly more of a challenge taking the bike back off of the lift without any assistance, because I have to tilt it back and forth to be able to get the frame blocks unmounted and get the entire lift out. So this should be fun. Let's watch. Alright, not too bad actually. So, walk the handlebars to go from the right to left, get all your pieces detached, and boom, it popped right off. So these are what I'm talking about if you didn't get a good view earlier. The frame rests through here, and it sits on this part right here. And this is the piece that goes in between the oil pan and the extra plate cover on the other side. So it sits like this with the, I guess it's like a crush rail right next to the oil pan sitting inside of the groove. And there you have it. That looks nice and clean. It's pretty functional. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to install my mirror extensions, which I have those. Those are drag specialties. I picked those up at my Harley dealership as well, but that was third party company. Looks pretty damn simple. I think I paid like 20 or 25 for these. Gonna give me a 2-inch lift on the mirrors, so that'll make things nice and handy. Well, that was a quick and easy answer. Drift specialties, piece of shit. This threading right here didn't even hold up for 10 seconds. It didn't even get like 10 foot pounds of torque before it just went to hell and back. So you're trying to get this installed, don't do it. Go aftermarket with a new pair of mirrors, or buy a new pair of Harley mirrors, something that's going to give you wider reach and get around your shoulders if you're having trouble seeing over them. So right now, this is not going to work at all. I'm going back to my stock rig with metal that's actually forged and doesn't suck ass. And I'm throwing this garbage where it belongs. Ugh. Fuck. Highly disappointing. Fuck. Alright, so final thoughts showing you where I'm at. I got the fender eliminator on, no problem. Well, it's not really a fender eliminator, it's relocator thingy. I took the strap off the seat because my girlfriend didn't need it, and I think it looks cleaner this way. The wire for the license plate light is entirely clear of the tire. Nothing to worry about there at all. I tried to get my saddlebags on, but what I'm seeing, those are my saddlebags. I picked them up at a convention in February in Columbus, and they're really nice and they're a good price. But what I'm seeing is that even at their most extended, it's resting above the swing arm, so I need to get a frame or something, because otherwise it's just going to bash into this tire. So saddlebag frame is incoming. The other cool thing that I got though at that convention was this little guy right down here. Little down tube bag, so I bought that and just mounted it on. That's a quick and easy install. It came with 2 leather straps. It's really clean. It's good quality leather. It's actually made in Cleveland, so I got 0 complaints there. I'm carrying currently tire repair kits in there because I've already had a blowout on my car since I got it, and my tire repair kit saved my ass. So now I carry tire repair kits with CO2 canisters for reinflation everywhere I go. But I mean, that's the final look of the bike with the relocator on there. And I'm pretty happy with it. I just look kind of naked in the back right now, but as soon as I get that saddlebag going, it's going to be nice and clean. So I apologize for this being long. I know this was kind of an in-depth one that I had crap everywhere right when you walked into it. But thank you for bearing with me. I appreciate it if you've watched this far. And I will be coming out with more riding videos here very shortly, as well as trying to figure out what to do with the mirrors. Still have to get a sissy bar and back pad and luggage rack for this thing. And then I'm going to be pretty close to done. Windshield. I got to get a detachable windshield. So I'm almost ready for Sturgis. I got some money in the bank already for it. It's only March right now, about to be April, and Sturgis isn't until August, but better to start early and be 100% ready to go. So Gary signing out. You guys have a great one. Thank you.